What's going on, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Madden NFL 16 Draft Champions. One win down and three more to go for the Draft Champions Championship. Looking at the team I put together in the last episode, Adrian Peterson, Mike Evans, Rob Gronkowski in the first round of tight end, AJ Green, Colt McCoy, quarterback, the offensive line not looking too bad either, and the defense, Jason Taylor, legend Jason Taylor, at left end, Kareem Jackson, Jimmy Smith, Eric Berry, Tank Carradine, Stephen Tulk, and Elvis Dumervil. We started off pretty hot in our first game, kind of slowed down towards the end. Can we repeat that performance just a little better here in our second game, as my opponent has John Elway, Jason Hatcher, and Zach Martin? So we'll start the game on defense. Billy Cundiff will kick off, and it'll be Ross returning from about the 10-yard line. Brennus went up the left side, and he will be wrapped up just shy of the 30. Ball at the 28-yard line for my opponent starting things out. Shotgun set, Matt Forte in the backfield. He gets the first play of the game on the ground, and Matt Forte spins away from Eric Berry, and he finds 8 yards, and he gets a near first down. I'm looking for Eric Berry to make up on that missed tackle as he'll go to the ground once again. Matt Forte up the middle this time. He is wrapped up, but still gets the first down. So first and 10 again. It's another carry for Forte, but this time Eric Berry there for the tackle, and we'll get a quick look at my opponent's offensive line. He's got 80 overalls across the line. The lowest guy is the center with an 82 overall. That's a pretty dangerous line. Screen set up here, 2nd and 7. He has blocks up the field. And look at Matt Forte trying to get this one down the field, juking inside, but wrapped up just shy of the 40 as that gets down to about the 41-yard line. This defense has to come up and make a stop. 2nd and 6, Jason Taylor gets to Matt Forte in the backfield. And that's going to be a gain of only 1 yard, bringing up 3rd down and 6 at the 36-yard line. Only 52 seconds left here in the first quarter. And my opponent finds his receiver across the middle. I think that's Alshon Jeffrey for the first down. We almost got there with Taylor just a second behind. 19 seconds left in the first quarter. Screen set up left side for Forte, but the defense is there. Good job by that defensive end. That's Tank Carradine bringing out Matt Forte. Big third down here in the second quarter, bringing pressure with Eric Berry as my opponent has Jimmy Graham against Elvis Dumervil, and Jimmy Graham will win that every single time. Touchdown for my opponent, and it's a 7-0 game. Here in the second quarter, we finally get on offense, and we're looking to run the ball with AP, something we didn't do a lot in the last game. AP gets a carry running left side and is brought down after a gain of no yards, as Asiata didn't really do too much blocking there. 2nd and 10 after the short run by AP. Pistol set, going play action pass. Defense sucks up, and I have no one open. Could have gone to Mike Evans on the comeback route, but I didn't want to test the user, and would dump it off to Asiata short for a gain of 5 yards, bringing up 3rd down and 5, so a very quick 3rd down. Trying not to go 3 and out. Dropping back here, not a lot of people open. Going to fire right side for Gronk, and Gronk can't break the tackle. 4th down upcoming, and we have to make a very tough decision here. Do we go for it on 4th down? And we will go for it. My opponent looking to stop the run. We'll go with the pass, and I'm going to drop back, try to get it to AP in the flat, and the game wouldn't let me throw it. I was pressing Y immediately, and I got hit with some type of lag spike, so my opponent takes over at the 25-yard line. We need a stop on defense. He'll fire towards the end zone, trying to go up quickly, 14-0, and Kareem Jackson somehow knocks that ball out of Alshon Jeffrey's hands. We caught a break. 2nd and 10, Matt Forte on the carry, trying to get outside. He won't get too many yards on this play. That's good for 2 yards, as that brings up 3rd down and 8. Needing a big stop here on 3rd down to keep my opponent to a field goal. He'll drop back, looking for a receiver downfield, running with John Elway, and Jason Taylor is there for the tackle to keep Elway from picking up the 1st down, but my opponent will go for it here on 4th down and 2. Can we return the favor and stop him on 4th down and short? He'll come out in the same formation. Matt Forte will get the carry up the field, and he will get the 1st down. I didn't want to run commit with a blitz because I was a little too worried about him going play action and having Greg Olsen, who I just now remember calling Jimmy Graham, open in the corner for a touchdown. So 1st and 10, Elway trying to run. It's going to be a fumble, and we can't recover. This guy just caught a break because that would have been a huge turnover at the end of the first half. He'll draw back again, this time firing for Matt Forte short, and I forced the ball loose, a user hit stick, and we get the ball back anyway. Big hit by Dumervil, I believe, forcing that one loose. 39 seconds left, 1st down and 10. I can see my opponent will be usering with the linebackers and the safety, so I'm going to fire it short for Gronk outside, and Gronk will pick up 5 yards. That's not really going to do too much for us with only 34 seconds left in the first half. We're trying to set the screen up on 2nd and 5, and I can see my opponent usering with the safety. I know he's coming on the blitz, so it's a perfect time for the screen going back the other way. And Adrian Peterson with blocks in front will only just barely get the first down. That could have been a much bigger play, but we just didn't get the block set in time. 1st and 10 once again, going to drop back, fire downfield. It's Mike Evans getting us past midfield, ball at the 44-yard line. And I should have called a timeout here. We're going to hurry back to the line, and that's going to burn a lot of time that we really didn't have. Going to drop back here, had Gronk wide open in the flat, and that is a costly sack here at the end of the first half. We could have at least gotten a field goal out of this possession, but mistakes were made as we'll pass over the middle for Gronk and trying to get down before the time expires, can't get it done. But we do get the ball at the beginning of the second half. So let's see what we can do offensively. Maybe build on some of the plays that we made in that first half, and this time maybe get some points on the board. Ross returning, trying to cut up field, and why are you running back towards the return man? Pick a lane, block somebody. 1st and 10 here, starting from the 26-yard line after that. Nearly taking a back kick return for a touchdown. Going to drop back, fire outside for Gronk. And bad decision. Had Mike Evans short over the middle. That could have been a near first down, but we'll only pick up 2 yards on that play. 2nd and 8, my opponent using with the safety once again. Going to drop back, look at Gronk open on the corner route. This is why you can't run man-to-man against this offense. I mean, we're going to find plays that work. And that time, Colt McCoy found Gronk for a big-time first down approaching midfield. Up the middle with AP. AP cutting up the defense, breaks one tackle, and we'll get down to about the 30-yard line on the dot for a big-time first down. AP finding some yards. Only at the one carry in the first play of the game for us offensively, 1st and 10. Ball at the 30-yard line, trying to go play action to fool the defense. Going to drop back, pressured, finding a linebacker. That pass is intercepted. I don't know what I was thinking on that throw, but mistakes are costing us points in this game. 1st and 10, my opponent goes back to the ground with Matt Forte, trying to run some clock here in the second half. And Matt Forte is just breaking all types of tackles. Broke 2 on that play. Late on the drive, facing 2nd down and 1. Ball pretty much near midfield, ball at the 48-yard line. My opponent will make adjustments. He'll drop back the pass. He'll fire outside. Has a man open. And he will walk into the end zone untouched as my corners, my 3rd and 4th string corners, these guys are slow. They can't keep up with Ross. They can't keep up with a lot of these other basic wide receivers who have pretty decent speed. 1st and 10, down by 14 points. Need to get something going here. Pass out quickly to AP. AP cuts up the field, breaks one tackle. And we'll get about 8 yards on that play. We got to go no huddle here for pretty much the rest of the game. 2nd and 2 this time. We'll go to the ground with Adrian Peterson. And, oh my gosh, I called a timeout out of frustration there because that tackle was BS. AP was gone. That makes it 3rd and 3. And that timeout could come back to haunt us as I'll drop back, pass downfield. And it's Mike Evans again. I had Gronk a little more open across the middle, but Mike Evans is the go-to guy here in this game. 1st and 10. We're down by 14. We need points in a hurry. Firing out for Adrian Peterson. Peterson juking inside. Has blocks downfield. Makes 2 guys miss. And AP will score. This game is not over yet. Gotta feed your playmakers. What a run after the catch by Adrian Peterson. 2-point conversion here. We'll go for it as I'll drop back and look at Mike Evans. Wide open possession catch. Easy catch. 2-point conversion is good. Only down by 6. We need to make stops on defense. And my opponent will start from the 7. After a holding call on the kick return, he'll try to get Matt Forte running up the middle here. He picks up 6 yards, bringing up 2nd and 4, and that will most likely take us to the 4th quarter, which it does. 2nd and 4, expecting another run here from Matt Forte. This time he does get it, running into traffic and brought down behind the line, as that will bring up another 3rd down. 3rd and 4, crucial play here. If we get the stop, we have a chance to get back in this game and potentially take the lead. But we need our defense to stop the run. This time it's a toss outside. I was not looking for that run. And Matt Forte will find big yards here, trying to juke Jimmy Smith. And Jimmy Smith not having it as he's brought down at the 42-yard line. We really could not afford that run. 2-minute warning just hit. My opponent going to the ground with Forte on a counter. And he is brought down behind the line. Eric Berry making the stop. 3rd down and 12. 1:57 left. If we get the stop here, this game could be ours. 3rd and 12, my opponent goes play action, trying to use it with Eric Berry. I went too far inside as he'll get the reception, but look at him celebrating too early. We recover the football. Oh my goodness. This guy made a mistake. You better hope we don't get down this field and score a touchdown. 1:49 left in the game. Plenty of time to get something going as we try to go to AP on the ground, and the run game just really has not been there for us today. Not having a lot of opportunities to run as we've been down for most of the game. 2nd and 10, dropping back, no one open on the slants across the middle. Gronk open in the flat, and Gronk. First down, 10 yards, down to the 24-yard line, 1:30 left. Got to get this ball a little further down the field. 1st and 10, going to drop back, dump it off the AP short. AP up the field as he will slip one tackle. And that's good for another 10 yards. Another pistol set here on 1st and 10. This time we go 3 wide receivers deep. Looking for A.J. Green across the field, and I can't get it off in time. The offensive line didn't do a great job of blocking Robert Lester with the sack. We lose out on a potential game-breaking play. 2nd and 17, back to the same play. This time my opponent will use her and cover that receiver, A.J. Green, outfield, and Gronk will lose the football at the 28-yard line, so 3rd and 16. Needing a first down, and I'm going to try to get it all on this play. I'll drop back the pass, looking for a man downfield, having Gronk and AP open in the flat. Ran out of time, had to throw downfield for A.J. Green in the triple coverage. That pass incomplete. 4th down. We have no choice but to go for it. And why are none of my big-time receivers on the field? Running out of time, having to fire for Gronk. Gronk going up, and he cannot hold on to the catch. My opponent forces the turnover. This is a heartbreaking end to the game. Gronk had it somehow. The ball is knocked free out of his hands. I don't know how that happened. But my opponent gets the ball back. He's going to march down the field. 3rd and 12, 5 seconds left. He's not going to run out the rest of the clock. Trying to go across the middle. This pass is intercepted by Jimmy Smith, and that'll do it. How epic would it have been if I could have run that interception back for a touchdown? But no dice, as we will lose here in our 2nd game with this team that had a lot of potential. So many breaks in this game where we could have taken the lead. We forced a fumble in the red zone. We got that interception after my opponent was, you know, gloating a little too early. And then we stripped the football, and then we just couldn't capitalize on those turnovers. I mean, we threw an interception, we had a fail 4th and short, and this game just really came down to me just not making great decisions. We only got one score in a game in the 3rd quarter, and then a 2-point conversion. Defense played all right, but obviously we got to start over with a brand new team, so that will be carried over into the next episode. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.